Meanwhile, a New York congressman is among a small group of lawmakers leading part of the next stimulus package. And the bill could bring more coronavirus relief funding to smaller communities like ours. Our Matt Knadler has more tonight.
A phase four package could pump hundreds of billions of dollars into state and local governments. But there is a growing push among House Republicans on Capitol Hill for that money to go directly to COVID-19 relief, not for governors to plug budget gaps that existed before the pandemic.
We have to protect those local governments from shenanigans that occur at the state capitals.
Chairs of the Problem Solvers Caucus, New York Republican Tom Reed and New Jersey Democrat Josh Gottheimer are leading the effort in House. They could introduce legislation as soon as Wednesday, an attempt to prevent governors from shifting money from one pot to another.
As a mayor, I was on the receiving end of that repeatedly, historically, traditionally, and that kind of bait and switch of taking out of their pocket the money they get from the federal government with budget adjustments.
Last month, Pennsylvania's Republican congressional delegation sent this letter to the Treasury Department requesting those safeguards. They fear a repeat of the bailout after the Great Recession, that governors will use federal relief funds to fill shortfalls at the state level for things like education and pensions.
If the problem that you're facing right now is coronavirus related, that's what these extra funds are for.
Writers of a Washington Post op-ed published Tuesday estimate COVID-19 will cost states $500 billion throughout the next fiscal year in lost income and sales tax revenue, plus paying skyrocketing unemployment claims. They add in another $65 billion for added health care costs. Previous funding included states and cities with more than 500,000 people. Reed wants this round to include smaller communities.
Communities of 500,000 people and less have received no assistance from the federal government.
And the Senate version of Reed's plan would offer state and local governments $500 billion.